L'analyse des flux de
The analysis of substance flows allows an analyzing the flow of molecules or simple chemicals within territories. These substances have their challenges, whether economic challenges, social challenges, or any other challenges. So once again, using the principle according to which nothing is created, nothing is lost, we will analyze the circulation of this component. In order to better illustrate the nature of this approach and all the challenges related to that, we are going to take a closer look at nitrogen. Nitrogen is a simple chemical which is present everywhere. The air contains 80% of nitrogen, and we consume nitrogen every day because it's included in proteins. So nitrogen is crucial for life. And what we can see on this graph that you can see now is the quantity of reactive nitrogen which is circulated each year in the atmosphere since the end of the 19th century. So what do we call reactive nitrogen? Nitrogen becomes reactive when it's in a molecule which has a positive or negative impact on the biosphere. This idea was introduced as an opposition to non-reactive nitrogen, which composes the atmosphere. And by the way, the word nitrogen means with no life. So it's not reactive when it's in the atmosphere, and when it penetrates the biosphere, it creates reactive molecules. The two straight lines that you can see on this graph give us an indication of the quantities of nitrogen which are naturally circulated in the biosphere and which allow the biosphere to operate properly. The other graphs give us an indication of entropic nitrogen, which also circulates within the biosphere. The black graph is the total, and we can see a significant increase since the 1950s. So today, the quantity of nitrogen which is released in the biosphere by populations excesses the natural cycle of nitrogen. More than 50% of nitrogen is of entropic origin. Several types of activities lead to this formation of entropic nitrogen. And the most important one is linked to the Haber-Bosch process, which by using nitrogen in the air produces ammonia, and ammonia is then used to produce fertilizers, and this is what led to the phenomenal increase in agricultural yields in the 20th century. It also allows producing explosives, which greatly contributed to the various wars in the 20th and 21st century. Alongside with the Haber-Bosch process, we see the importance of growing rice and sugarcane that increase the bacterial fixation of nitrogen as it occurs naturally in ecosystems. And the third origin of reactive nitrogen is combustion of fossil fuels. So in total, we can say that the nitrogen cycle is an open biogeochemical cycle, because circulated quantities are far more important than they would be naturally, and they lead to storage effects, that's a disruption of the cycle in the biosphere. This opening up of the nitrogen cycle leads to a large number of dysfunctionings within the biosphere. We sometimes talk about the nine damages of nitrogen according to a European project called Nine, Nitrogen in Europe, and like nine, the nine plagues of nitrogen. So there is aquatic pollution, pollution. There is coastal eutrophication with the proliferation of algae due to the excessive quantity of nitrates in water, and nitrates are made up of nitrogen and oxygen. But it's also the loss of biodiversity linked to eutrophication. It's acidification of soils and water. It's the transformation of stratospheric chemistry and production of ozone. It's the release of greenhouse gas and contribution to climate change. It's damages on plants and damages on the quality of urban air and the release of particles. So the nine plagues of nitrogen demonstrating that we absolutely must take this into consideration if we want and improve the operation of our societies.